It is a fact our ancestors used to eat very differently from us. Bread, for example, a very common food today, was made by hand in the old days. But now, many families find it more convenient to buy bread at the supermarket. What most people don't know, however, is that these foods are full of preservatives. Do you know what preservatives are and what types of it there are? Today we will talk about the food preservatives that you should avoid. Food preservatives are chemical substances that can be either natural or synthetics and are added to a product, in this case a food, to extend its shelf life, protecting it from bacteria, fungi, yeast, and other kinds of organisms or chemical reactions that may turn the food improper for consumption. The use of food preservatives is common, and that's why we don't pay much attention to it. But if you get into the habit of reading labels, you will notice it. Even though they are now something common, there are some substances found in food preservatives that are harmful to our health and can cause allergies, gastric issues, and even cancer. According to studies, the preservative called sodium benzoate and food colorings can cause symptoms of attention deficit disorder in children. Did you know that? It really is something worrisome. Because of that, it is important to pay attention to what you are eating. Many foods are full of preservatives, but some of them really take the cake, as is the case with dairy, pre-made sauces and beverages, sausages, snacks, and cookies. The most common types of preservatives are antimicrobial, antioxidant, and enzymatic inhibitors. Are you enjoying this video? Give it a thumbs up and help our channel. Antimicrobials act by killing and inhibiting the growth of microorganisms that can change the food's quality. An example of an antimicrobial preservative is salt. When we put salt on meat, it absorbs all the water from the food, which prevents the meat from absorbing more humidity from the ambient air. Since the microorganisms are left without any water to reproduce, meat lasts for a longer time. Antioxidant preservatives prevent the product reacting with oxygen, avoiding any damages to the product. Just like oxygen oxidizes iron, it can also oxidize an apple. You know when you cut an apple and it darkens? It is reacting to the oxygen. A good example of a very common antioxidant is ascorbic acid, vitamin C. Do this test. Cut an apple in half and apply a few drops of orange or lemon on one half of the apple. You will notice that the part left without anything darkens faster than where you applied some drops of lemon. The same happens with potatoes, but since it has an enzyme called catechol oxidase, it darkens very quickly after being peeled or grated. Enzymatic inhibitors act as preservatives of these enzymes, preventing the acceleration of the reactions that change the physical and chemical state of products. Isn't it interesting? Usually, food preservatives are shown in the product's package, either by its name or its number code. An advantage of using preservatives is that foods and products can be preserved for a longer time, avoiding contamination of people. The big disadvantage is that food preservatives may be linked to diseases and disturbances like autism and obesity. Some studies have concluded that the artificial preservatives used in many processed foods possibly increase the risk of inflammatory diseases, metabolic disturbances, and obesity. The same preservatives that affect microorganisms can also affect human health. If you are going to consume them, do it with moderation. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. For more recipes and tips, subscribe to the channel.